Joe and I are heading off to Vancouver Island on an adventure to do a 7-day survival challenge. Here we go. I'm Greg Ovens, and this is Ovens Rocky Mountain Bushcraft. So, Joe showed up. You remember Joe from the mushroom video? He brought me that awesome moose roast. That was so old. Oh, that was good, buddy.
Hard to beat moose, eh?
You can't.
Well, that moose is unbelievable.
But Joe and I are heading off to Vancouver Island on an adventure and to do a 7-day survival challenge. I think it was Joe that actually wanted to do this.
I was looking forward to it, actually. I've never tried one of these before, so.
Yeah, so it'll be a great adventure. We're going to do other things, but we're going to spend 7 days in probably a remote area on Vancouver Island. Berries should be out, lots of plants, so we shouldn't have to struggle. We're going to bring our coffee, a few items, as you'll see. But we're ready to get out of here, leave the teepee, and head to the island. We're out of here. Well, let's get on the road, man.
On the road.
On the road. Here at the Tuolumne River, we're going to do a little bit of gold panning. I found some really nice coarse gold right in this area, in this canyon. So we're going to give it a shot. Maybe even try to catch a fish. It is exciting though. I love this spot. You're going to love the scenery of this canyon and this river, the Tuolumne. Joe kind of challenged me on this 7-day that we're going to do on the island, and he says he's going to try to outfish me. I think he's going to try to outsmart me too with traps. He's got an idea for a crab trap. So I like a challenge. I mean, it's interesting. It's going to be awesome. I like a challenge, like I say, and I've got some ideas of my own, and let's see who catches the most fish on this adventure. I hope you guys are rooting for me.
I'm an avid fisherman. I love fishing. Yep. And I know Greg is a world-class fisherman himself. So
I love my fishing. So we'll see who catches the most. So leave your comments below. Does Joe outfish Greg in this 7-day challenge? I don't know. What do you think?
I think so.
Here we are on the island. I'm going to show you a neat little town here, and we're going to get this adventure underway shortly.
We won't go hungry.
Oh, interesting anyways, that these oars grew into the tree, and then one day a cougar showed up on the boardwalk, grabbed a little dog, somebody broke one off and fought the cougar off, but that's all they had for a weapon apparently, according to the sign. Hard to get though. You never know where they're going to come up. Oh yeah.
Get our Zodiac out there. Is that gonna be safe with them around, huh?
Some killer whales on the video. Right on. That's Captain Joe. Yeah. Yeah, everybody's going kayaking. So no fish for us. We're kind of just scouting locations right now, and it's pretty rocky shore. I don't see a lot of plants really, so it could be tough go for me and Joe. It looks like you got a sunburn.
I do.
Joe made a trip. We're going to an island off the mainland here, and he took a bunch of stuff over. We have to bring water. We don't know if we have water over there. We're going to bring some coffee. We picked up some crab and prawn traps. We're going to use fishing rods. So we'll see how we can do over on the island there. We are going to try to catch and cook our own food though. And the other thing is we can't have fires. There's still a fire ban. We got to bring the stove and propane bottles. But I still want to catch the most fish and the most crab and the most prawns. I doubt I'm going to beat him on every count. That's not likely. He's a pretty avid outdoorsman as well. But we're going to have fun and hopefully you'll enjoy the adventure. This is day one of the 7-day adventure on an island off from the main island. It'll be cool. Right on.
Say hi, Greg.
Hey, that's good lighting. I like that.
There you go.
Heading to the island. Our secret island.
Yeah, our secret adventure. Right out around the cove here as we leave this bay. The killer whales were just there about 10 minutes ago. So
maybe we'll see them again.
Yeah, hopefully they're hanging out and we get to accompany them on their fishing trip.
Well, hopefully they spook the salmon to us.
That's right. Good luck. There's a big one right there. Here in our cove, Greg.
Well, this is going to be the home for a while.
Yeah.
A few days.
Well, it's good to be out in the bush again, eh?
I just get out here, then I never want to leave.
That's right.
Until I'm forced out.
Beautiful reishi mushroom that we've seen. Quite big. It's massive. Beautiful. Perfect condition and everything.
So I'm just going to bait my crab trap up. I'm using chicken liver, and I think Joe is using turkey necks or legs or...
Turkey necks.
So we're going to see whose bait works the best. So just load the trap up, get her down. There should be crab almost anywhere along here. That's what we're thinking anyway. We'll see. Okay? Well, Joe caught the first fish. He just dropped it down. We just started fishing. And then he got this right away. Show off. Rockfish.
That's a big one. Want to net it?
Here. Well, there's dinner.
Ceviche.
Hey.
You got something.
That's awesome. Oh. Thanks, Greg.
For what?
Rugged little buggers. I don't want to get spined.
Yeah, they can really spine you.
Now, you don't find much tastier than that right there. Beauty.
Gregor got one. It feels pretty decent, too. So, one for one. We're still tied. It didn't take long. We only been out here 5 minutes.
Well, you don't have it to the boat yet, Greg. Oh, don't be man. So confident. Well, you know who you're competing against, right?
Maybe it's a halibut.
Oh, well, then, that's extra points.
Just take my time. I never panic to reel them in. That's how guys lose them. Just keep the pressure on.
There he is. See
oh,
fish.
That's a good one.
That's another nice one.
Big one, yeah.
You want to net it?
Yeah.
Doesn't look too hooked.
Man, they're sure nice size Dude. Around here.
How many are we allowed?
Three.
Three?
Yeah.
It's quite the colors.
Lots of spines.
So, Joe just caught his second one. I just caught my second one just a while ago. So, we're thinking we're only allowed three of these. Maybe we'll get our three and do some salmon fishing. So we got to set up camp. There's stuff to do. I'd rather actually be out salmon fishing than fishing for these rockfish. So maybe that's what we'll do soon. I've actually caught three of the rock crabs so far. Joe had his second one on, but it was very tiny, and he let it go. So 2 to 3. Well, one really, because he didn't keep the one. It's who keeps the most.
This is Vance is killing me, yeah.
Well, I got my salmon.
It popped good. Okay, now slowly pull her up. You might have to hold the camera.
Let's just try to get the fish.
There he is, right there. It's a salmon.
Okay, well, he's going this
okay,
side.
Okay, we're going to have to shut this off, folks.
My first salmon of the trip. I didn't want to lose it, I can tell you that. Nice. Got my salmon, my sockeye salmon, right on, man. So that's four fish for today. I'll be eating good for the whole trip now, even if I don't get anything else. Joel's got a couple of crabs in there. The rock crab. The one looks like a Dungeness. But they only have to be four and a half inches. So we got to check and see. One looks like it might be legal. Just little guys. We know this guy's not legal. That's obvious. No, he doesn't want to let go.
That's a female.
Yeah, we can't keep the females either. Boy, this little guy, he doesn't want to come out.
Female.
Of course, they're all females now.
This is the one I thought might be a female.
We're all females.
All females.
So far.
These rock crab, they get a hold of something, and man, they don't want to ever.
Joe had four crab in his rock crab, but they were all female and too small anyway. We'll see if I got any action with my trap here. And we're not all that deep either, really. Mine's heavy. Not because of crab, it's metal. Well, he's
always on the outside.
He's on the outside of the trap.
Get him up here, we've got to measure him.
What do you mean, measure him?
He's definitely too small, huh?
That's amazing.
Oh, look. All my
and
livers
it's a female.
Are gone.
A lot of females here. Look at him. There he goes.
Hmm.
Awesome how they swim, eh?
Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put one of these fish heads in there.
while we're here before I reset it. So I want some fish head in there. The liver is half gone. I don't know if they're pulling it through or what they're doing, but we put a big fish head on so that they can't pull that through. Look at this. Look at this fish. These are probably these little ones that are jumping. Whole little fish in them. Isn't that wild? Pretty cool. That's just a snack. I'm just kidding. So, success though.
It was an awesome day out on the water. Greg caught the first salmon. I caught the first fish. And we had an awesome day. We're gonna be eating good tonight.
Well, it's not looking like we're gonna go hungry. I mean, we got like six fish already. I got four. Joe got two, and I got one salmon. We thought it was a sockeye, but actually it's a coho. So, just to get the record straight here, it's a coho. Out, Finn. Go. Don't eat my fish, man.
That is sharp, eh? Mm-hmm. Amazing. Look at it.
Well, those Joker knives are really good, man.
They're amazing. Look at that.
I know. I like those knives.
Those are awesome. Not a flay knife, but man, is it doing a heck of a job.
Well, I mean, a sharp knife is what you have to have.
Yeah, exactly. Follow that bone. You want to keep the belly or yeah?
Well, we can keep crab bait.
Yeah. So what I like to do is I like to leave the tail attached, just a little bit of skin like that.
Yeah.
Lay it on a flat rock. This helps to de-skin it. Look at that piece of meat. Man. Beautiful.
Try not to hit the rock with the knife.
Yeah, no.
I don't want to dull it. That's a nice fillet. You want to show the camera that one.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Perfect. And it's great for a hunting knife, eh?
Oh, it's a great knife.
Awesome job.
This is nice and soft. Got a big cedar on an angle. Huge cedar, actually. Boy, would that be something if the tree decided to pull out by the roots while you're sleeping under it. It's on quite an angle. But I think it's been here quite a long time, so I think I'm okay. We'll just set our bed up, just a blanket, but like I say, it's been pretty dry. I will set a tarp up, but I don't think it's going to rain. I don't think I'm going to even worry about that tonight. Day one, caught lots of fish. The blanket's not as big as I thought it was. But it'll do. It'll do. Is that going to be comfortable? I think that's too much of an angle. That's too much of an angle. I'm just going to keep sliding. I got to find somewhere else. I'm not liking that spot. I'm just going to keep sliding. be better. So anyway, even though, you know, we're using the boat for fishing, this and that, got the crab traps, we bought those. Still roughing it in the sense that I'm going to sleep on the ground. That little blanket is a lot smaller. I should have read the size on it. I guess it's not very big, but it's warm enough. Doesn't look like it's going to rain. I probably should set the tarp up because it could change in the night. But I'm under these big trees too. I think it's going to be fine. Do I take a chance or before dark do I set the tarp up? Leave your comments below. But now I'll give it away. I'll probably set the tarp up. Good spot for my anchor power pack though too. My batteries are getting low. Got to keep stuff charged. This will be perfectly dry even if it rains. I won't have to worry about tarping this spot for the power pack. Whew. Yeah, I didn't really like the idea of sleeping with a tree this size on an angle like that either, really. Camera gear. Geese. No, it's not geese, that's ducks. It's charging. Perfect. Get this tarp set up in case the weather changes. So, first night on the island here, and I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. This blanket sucks. It can't cover you. It wasn't warm. I would have been better off bringing my survival blanket from the last video. It would have been 10 times warmer. This blanket is warm. It's that good. I mean, I don't have time to make a survival blanket. There doesn't look to be a lot of use in you, so I want to sleep proper. That was pretty miserable, actually, to be honest. But I'll have to show you down here. We're going to have to wait for the tide to come back in because the boat's just sitting on the rocks now. So we'll find some adventure to do on the island until the tide comes back in. I'll show you the boat. Morning, Greg.
Morning.
How was your sleep?
Terrible.
Now we'll get some good bedding, eh, for today?
It's right up there with the killer lake. I'm not bringing any bedding. May as well not have brought any.
Some are dead, some aren't. So in low tide, we could probably go through here and find some to boil up. Right on. Food everywhere on the island. So just doing a little hike through this little corridor here and found some fallow deer tracks. They're very, very tiny deer that are on the island here and the other little islands around. Tracks are only, they're very tiny deer.
We're in here now looking for a few mushrooms.
It'd be awesome to see some chicken in the woods or something. Lots of slugs. It gets really bad. Start boiling those big boys up. There's so many of them. There's a nice big one here too. So he doesn't resort to that. So I found my first velvet top bullet. These are very tasty. I usually make them into like chili or add them to like burrito meat or fajitas. They're great. Even in lentil soup, they're an amazing, amazing mushroom. The Admiral Bleak. And we'll be chefing that guy up. He's in perfect shape. You couldn't find nicer. So we'll be looking for a few more of those. Fry them up with some fresh fish or maybe some mussels. Should be tasty. Very unique. My kind of country. Awesome for mushroom picking, that's for sure. You can see everywhere. Look at the size of that stump. There's a monstrous tree here. Those, folks, are winter chanterelles. Yellowfoot chanterelle. Just take the biggest one so you can see. And they are completely tasty. They're very tasty. But they're just tiny, they're just starting. So this must be a microclimate. I don't think you'll find very many more. There's something going on there that's really cold. There's some more. I said that we probably wouldn't find any more, but there are quite a few here. Oh, I don't want to ruin him. Wish I had a little basket with me. Not a lot, but it's enough for a meal. These are winter chanterelles. Beauties. There's not lots of them, but they'll make a perfect addition to some fried up fish. It's amazing how dried the stems are. They crack and break off, but they're still very good and edible. And they'll soak up some of the juices from the fish and turn out perfect. My pathway in the forest sometimes. The easiest route, a log. Now I came over here to see what those are. From a distance I couldn't tell. I'm suspicious they're gold. Golden chanterelles. Oh, beautiful. Absolutely perfect. You can see it's been dry. That's what happens to the stem when it's been a dry year. But those are perfecto. Greg's gonna be blown away. Look at that. That's gorgeous. Amazing. And that's one of my favorite mushrooms on the planet right there. It has a nice flavor of light hint of apricot or fruit. And man, does it make awesome gravies. Incredible gravies, sauces, pastas. There's obviously a microclimate in here because this one's very far along. It's got a hole in the top of it already. A little bit of brushing off. It'll be just as tasty as the rest. And you're out here trying to eat what you find. Can't be that picky. Golden chanterelles. Perfecto.
I was only in there half
half an hour, and you should see what I found. It's incredible.
Perfect. Rocks work fairly well, not as good as an actual sharpener, but they work. You can at least keep somewhat of an edge on them with rocks.
Greg. Five-second rule. Just poach those up for a bit.
I could almost use a nap once I get some bedding. You know what I
mean?
Yeah,
when you don't have a good sleep like
that. Oh, it's terrible.
It's very hard on that.
And that's the important thing when you're on the show, sleeping at night.
Yeah.
And it can be tough if you got bears around. But I mean, like I say, I slept really good in Patagonia, but there was no predators really. Cougars and the pigs.
Yeah.
And I didn't worry about either one. Mm-hmm.
Were you allowed, you guys hunted the pigs, eh, or no?
Well, yeah. That's why I was setting snares and stuff.
Yeah.
And then the fox kept wrecking my traps.
Oh, I remember that, yeah. Look at that. Beautiful. It was a nice score finding the golden chanterelles. They're going to go perfect with that white fish. Greg's going to be blown away. Greg, have you ever had golden chanterelles? No? Golden chanterelles, some beautiful fresh fish, and a view that's pretty amazing. The salmon are calling, Greg.
Well, they're calling me. I don't know about you.
So just trying those chanterelles and the rockfish. We did bring butter as well, because you gotta have butter with the crab and the stuff that we're catching here. Those chanterelles are really good, man. But that rockfish, extremely good. The only thing better, I think, is maybe the salmon. As long as we get one fish a day with the mushrooms, we got some mussels, we're not going to starve here. So hopefully I can get another salmon today. The rockfish, they just seem so easy to catch that it's not even really sport. You go out and every 5 minutes you have one of those. So we'd be able to get our limit and finish out this adventure quite easily just on the rockfish even. But we're going to go out pretty quick. The water's coming in right now, just touching the back of the Zodiac, so we should be able to go and check the crab traps pretty quick here. Then, like I say, I got to go and get a proper sleeping situation going here, because it's just not very comfortable. We're going to go check our crab traps pretty quick here. So what we did when we were in town, we didn't bring a tape measure or anything, but we did mark off on this piece of cardboard. We got three lines here, 4.5, which is good for rock crab. That's the limit for them. 5.5
and 6.5. So I'm just going to take a stick, line it up, and notch the 4.5 and 6.5. 6.5 for Dungeness and 4.5 for the rock crab. And then we got a ruler so we don't get in trouble. Dungeness. It'd be nice to get the Dungeness. They're a little better tasting crab for sure. All air on the other side of the mark to make sure that it's the right size. Okay, so I got my two little notches. One here, right at the end. So now we got our measuring stick. Throw that in the fishing box, tackle box, and we're good to go. Check the traps. Boy, I hope we got some crab to go with the fish that I'm gonna catch today. So, and what we decided with the prawn trap is we'll just share one because the water's so deep. We won't keep track of the prawns just because it's like 300 feet deep and we don't wanna be using two traps for that. So we're just gonna keep track of the fish and the crab that we catch on this trip or whatever else that we get. Little guy. You got him. Okay, you can point it at me.
Oh, he fell through.
He went through. Where'd he go through?
He went through. They turned sideways in this thing.
Oh, for Christ.
I bet that was close to keeper size.
Yeah. Oh, I think so.
Look at this one, it's putting on a show, Greg.
Yeah, I know. You're too close to them jumping and they don't see the boat.
Yeah.
They're huge, man. They're probably catching salmon.
Smaller fish usually are like... Can you video for now?
Huh?
Can you video for now?
What do you want me to do?
Well, I just gotta pull up my line.
I see.
Whale.
Well, the whales are all around us.
It's getting heavy. Look at him. He's coming right at us.
Oh my God. You better get out of here, man.
How?
What do you mean, how?
You're not allowed to run your motor beside them, Greg.
And get your bait out of the water.
Like start paddling or what? You better get ready. He's coming right up underneath of us or past us or something. Because we're not allowed to run the motor, so we better just calm down, I guess. He's swimming right underneath us.
He's gonna come up over there.
Right near us.
Past us, I would say.
And I don't see that other one that was jumping.
Look at the little ones right there, the porpoises.
Yeah.
There was a giant one that just swam under our boats, like monster. That was his blowhole, and his whole body was about four times the size of our boat.
Well, that's why, the way that one jumped, if it landed on your boat, good night.
There'd be no more Rocky Mountain bushcraft, that's for sure. It'd be Captain Arab. Weird how they can just vanish like that, eh? That's what's eerie about them. They can just disappear.
There he is.
There he is, going into there. See? Amazing how they can... The distance he traveled on one breath. Look at the porpoises. They're chasing... Oh, look at... There's a pile of porpoises coming our way right there.
Little peninsula.
Amazing, eh? Another big one over there. we could have caught that on footage when he did the whole mark.
Oh, when he was jumping.
That was magnificent. Oh. Like, to the sheer momentum to launch an animal that size.
There's another big one way over there. Look.
Yeah. There's something going on special this week in this bay, eh?
Well, we're going to see a lot more of it, I'm sure.
Yeah. Man.
So what we do when we go fishing is we leave Finn at camp. He knows where camp is. He doesn't go anywhere. But I had to put a couple of fish up in the tree because he will get into that. He's an opportunist, like most dogs are. So I just got back from town. I picked up a couple of better blankets, so should be able to sleep better now. We're going to cook up some fish. What happened today was I caught one more rock cod, and Joe caught two. So with the fish count, he's only one behind me with the fish count. But at the same time, he caught one crab in his trap that was legal. So he has the first crab. Oh, and also he caught four prawns. And neither one of us caught salmon today. I'm lagging as far as numbers, but ahead on fish, no crab for me yet. It's pretty close contest so far. But anyway, get this bed set up better tonight. And tomorrow is day three, so stay tuned for day three.
We're coming up to my crab trap here.
Okay. Prawns.
Well, that's great.
Those are going to be tasty.
Joe got a cod.
Show your cod off then, Joe.
Oh, look at that.
He's beating me. Wait, the spines.
Breakfast of champions.
The sea started getting rough, and then it got worse and worse. We ended up leaving Finley. I just hope he's okay. I worry about the little guy.
Finn!